Thank you. There you go. Coming of age, coming of age is not easy. In the coming of age, we need all your support. Because it's not what you say, what you do. Sometimes just, let me rephrase that, it's not what you say, sometimes what you do. They see everything, and good character is something that they never forget. But when you show good character, it goes to them. Well, coming of age is extremely important for all of us. At this time, we're going to play something from West Africa that's played for teenagers when they're coming of age. And you may have heard it many times, but like I told you before, our music never gets old. Kakilambe. Very easy.
Come on, let's go. Stand for a minute, please. The leader who initiates the libation calls upon the community for its participation. As the water is poured upon the earth, we ask that all of you respond with Ashe and that the confetti. Ancient kings and queens of Africa who understood that when you practice Maat, that results in personal development. And we say,
Ashe.
We pour for all of those Africans that fought and died, some names we know, like Queen Nzinga, some that ended up in the Atlantic Ocean, some that ended up in the Indian Ocean.
for their energy to be a part of us. We'll say, Ashe.
Next, we pour to the children, to whom we pledge our love and protection. And also to those personal ancestors, some of whom may have been parents, may have just been friends in your family, but those people that helped you and taught you how to walk and talk and told you what was right and wrong. And we say,
I say.
Ella Darrell said, and I want to repeat, everything we do is for our eternity. And our eternity are the Watoto, the children. We pour, we live, we work for our children. We'll say, Ashe.
Ashe.
Next, we pour to those brave men and women who fought that good fight. Those women like Ida B. Wells and Sojourner Truth and Harriet Tubman. And those men who died, whose blood, whose bodies lay in a puddle, whose bodies died in a puddle of blood, who never got a chance to see their families again, like Malcolm and Megan Evans, Martin. And we say,
I say.
And lastly, we pour for our African people as we stand, as we support each other, as we protect each other, as we protect African people wherever we are. We pour for ourselves as we stand here, honoring our past, honoring our future. We'll say, Ashe,
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 Ashe.
So for our ancestors who came by force and the ones who are already here, we want to acknowledge them.
I say.
And those who didn't make it, those who died and struggled for our freedom, for our life, for our futures, they died because they chose to not bring their children into this horror that they were traveling in. Some died because they didn't want their children to be brought into who were children of rape and torture and abuse. They didn't want them to participate in this world to come. And those of us who died because they fought and struggled, and that's one thing I really saw when I went to the African American Museum in D.C. If y'all haven't gone, go.
Yes.
But in that museum, I saw that no matter where our encounters were with our opposition and our oppression, we resisted, even to this very day. We're still resisting. And so I must acknowledge those who fought and resisted oppression and slavery and torture and mutilation and all those violent crimes that were created upon us people and humanity. I say. And then for those of us who we know, and at this time, these are the ones we want to bring forward in our memory of them as we go around and just mention their name and say something very short of why you want us to remember them on your behalf. And I'll start. With the female. I'll start by just saying I want to acknowledge my dad, Robert Shelton. He's somebody who I've never met. He died when my mother was in her third month carrying me. Mm-hmm. And so I carry his spirit with me everywhere I go. Even though I haven't seen him, all the things that he's done, I've done playing instruments and singing and traveling and all that. You know, it's like I've been reborn in him. So for him to say, I share.
I say.
Blessed to come from a strong family lineage, but every time we get together, I cannot
help but remember our brother Quinde Kim Clinton, who always encouraged us to read. And so for that, I want to remember him.
I say.
I want to remember my father, Willie Fred Vinson, who inspired me to be where I am.
I'd like to remember Brother John Fuller, Dr. Darrell DeCufo, and Brother Ibrahim, who gave me my acknowledgement and knowledge of what it was to be a black man.
I say.
I want to honor Gladys Patton, who was my grandmother, just for being able to make something out of nothing so that her family could exist.
I say.
I want to honor my grandfather, Edward G. Robinson. And he, after the death of my father, he gave me the male perspective on everything and actually became the very essence of me this kind of right now.
So I say.
I like to acknowledge MZ Garrett. She always pushed me to think further and go deeper and to always read and learn more about who I am. And always encouraged me in my spirituality and my history.
I'd like to honor Fred Johnson. Met him at a Kwanzaa maybe about 25 years ago. A couple of years later, he says, you know, a bunch of us old guys are getting together and helping out at this new Stewart school. Why don't you come by? I told him I didn't necessarily like the old guys part, but, but I would come by. So that led me to 9 years of some awfully great experiences that I thank Fred for.
Let's remember my mother, Pearl Smith, who was a single parent and raised four children.
I want to take a time to remember my grandma, Lillian Jackson. She inspired me to go to stay in school, go to college, get a well-paid job, and just stay out the streets and just be smart about my consequences and my situations, and be smart in everything I do.
I'd like to remember my mother, Mary Franco, who adopted me when I was three, took me out of a very difficult situation, raised me to be a strong woman, God-fearing woman, and I loved her very much.
I
want to remember my uncle, Iman Abdul Madiun. He and I were, for some reason, were going through tough times during the late 60s and 70s. And we shared experience, and he guided me through what I was going through. He was very close to El Hajj Malik Shabazz in Chicago and Gary, Indiana. So it was through his tutelage that I know that's why I do a lot of what I do in the way that I do it. So I remember him this day in the Sasa.
I say.
I'd like to remember my mother, Ellen Mostella. A single mother, didn't graduate high school. I didn't know a lot of the struggle, but she took care of her family and her children and her one of her children's children. And bought our first home on West Side of Akron and made sure we were okay. So my mother, Ella Mostella, died.
I
want to honor my mom. She's pushed me to be a better person, be a person to have an education, have a job, have a life.
Yeah.
I want to give honor to great-great-grandparents. There was Liddy and Solomon Underwood on my grandmother's side, my mother's side. And Preston and Elizabeth Westbrook. The Flints were carriage makers back in the day. They were able to move around. But the story goes through oral tradition that they were very proud people. They made everything. They played the violin, and they made carriages. And that flame tradition has moved on over the centuries, where it laid a foundation for us, whether we chose to take a part in it or not.
I say.
I'd like to honor my great-grandfather's little brother as a freedom fighter. He ran away from home when he was 12 to join the Union Army, and he came back with a cavalry sword.
I'd like to give honor to my mother, whose life was short, relatively short. She died at age 53. But in those 53 years, she was able to rear her three children against a lot of odds, life circumstances, so much so that it landed her in, she had a nervous breakdown, landed her in a hospital, and caused us to be adopted into foster system. To which we were returned to her when she got better. But I, as an adult, can see now the many struggles that she went through and what she was trying to do as a mother. And in spite of all of the life challenges that she did have, she was able to instill in her children the good things that one wants in life. You know, pursue your education, you know, be a good person. So I like to give honor to my mother, Mariella Wright Bowen.
I say.
I'd like to honor my mother and father, Lucille and Jimmy Dent. He always told me, if you honor your mother and father, your days will be longer. And like they always taught me to pray. And I'm 940 months old, and 28,000 days old.
Come on, bro.
I want to honor my mother, Ruby McClinic. She was just a quiet woman.
I say.
Imani. That is the principle of the day. Imani means faith. And when I think of faith, I think of Mary McLeod Bethune. With $1.50, she had faith that she could start a school, and she did. And that school has become Bethune-Cookman University. And she says in her legacy, faith. Without faith, we can do nothing. With faith, anything and everything is possible.